The Technogym Skillrun Unity 7000 treadmill has 20 controls, 50 tiles, and too many submenus and settings to count. I couldn't get it all edited by my publishing deadline, so in this part 1 video, I'll give you a walkthrough of all the on-screen and physical controls. Then part 2 will cover all the tiles, their submenus and settings, and part 3 will cover the hidden system settings. To begin, touch the screen to turn off the screensaver. There are two home screens. This one is the main home screen, and this one is the exercise home screen, and both are composed of tiles and controls. The Unity 7000 screen uses three touch control methods: single touch, touch and drag, and touch and hold. You can always get back to the main home screen or exercise home screen by touching this home button. Next to the home button is the back button, which takes you to a previous screen in some circumstances, and the rest of the time it also brings you back to the home screen. You can touch on the right arrow to scroll right, or the left arrow to scroll left, or you can touch and drag right or left. Touch the Bluetooth button to connect your wireless heart rate band, smartphone, or wireless headphones or earbuds, and touch the X Close button on the bottom left, or the Circle X Close button on the top right to close this screen. Touch the Audio button to adjust the volume. This console doesn't have speakers, so for audio, you'll have to use headphones, earbuds, or connect external speakers. If you have headphones that use a wire or external speakers, there's an audio jack on the left side of the console next to a USB charging port you can use to charge your phone. The performance status bar at the bottom of the screen during exercises can be touched to expand it to show additional performance metrics or to change some settings such as speed or incline. I'll go over all the tiles in part 2. But I'll mention three tiles here because they're control tiles. This is the Swift Pad tile, which allows you to change speed or incline with a single touch. If you prefer to go by pace instead of speed, just touch the Speed Pace button to change the Swift Pad from one to the other. While you're exercising, many screens show a stop tile, and some also show a cool down tile. Screens such as the login screen have a screen keyboard. There's a hidden system settings button just to the right of the home button, which I'll go over in part 3. Now I'll point out the physical controls. To the right front of the console is the speed shifter, and you push it forward to speed up the tread and pull it back to slow down. The shifter on the left is called the incline shifter, and you push it forward to increase the incline and pull it back to lower it. However, when you're in one of the pre-programmed workouts with a 1 to 25 effort level, both shifters will change the effort level up or down. On top of the handlebar is a stop button, which will end any exercise, and on the bottom front of the console is a stop cord, which can be coiled up around the clip and snapped into a storage spot underneath the console if you don't plan to use it. Finally, there's a power on-off switch and two breaker reset buttons behind a lift-up panel at the right front of the treadmill. That's it for this video. But be sure to watch part 2 to see all the tiles, their submenus, and settings, and part 3 to see the hidden system settings. And always remember to keep walking, running, or sprinting.